Billy, I want you to meet four of my girls. Billy's going to be living with us.
Hi.
I don't think you're ready for any serious romance until you get your head on straight.
Can you name one guy you honestly trust?
I don't get it.
Division would be behind that smoke.
That's real encouraging, Nick.
Hey, I thought you volunteered for this recon.
It's been a horrible mistake. I'm classified clerk typist.
Yeah, well, the complaint department is that way. Grab your Smith Corona and let's move it out. Joey the Jabon.
You bum. You get to chase English nurses and me. I'm fit for duty.
You smell better, I'd kiss you.
Hey, that's great. Hold it. Come on. Smile like it's prom night.
Anyway, where's my corsage?
So Joey Galanto was a real hero.
You won a bronze star for that. Mother heard she started cooking right through VE Day. Today, Galanto Development is the biggest contractor in the tri-state area. So is Joey, for that matter. 250 pounds. Mama's still cooking.
You're cute, Nick.
I'm still cute.
Nick, I understand about Joey and everything, but this kid...
Billy's Joey's only son. Hey, I was a godfather before I was a father.
We know that, but it's just gonna be kind of strange having a boy hanging around.
I don't know what you're worried about. We've got plenty of room.
What does he look like?
Let's see what I got. I guess he's the last picture I have on him. Cute kid, huh?
Aye. Looks harmless enough.
He's kind of dorky looking.
It's a little picture. He's grown up now.
How come he isn't going to school?
He was. He, just decided to take a semester off. Joey saved my life. He's family. So's Billy.
Don't worry, Nick. We'll make him feel welcome.
Great. I'm counting on
it. Something wrong, Gup?
No, I just left out a few details about the kid.
Billy's not the apple of his parents' eye?
Billy was a sweet, bright kid. And he gets kicked out of two prep schools, barely graduates. Now his father tells me he just walked out in his freshman year of college.
Well, not everyone is academically inclined.
Billy was straight A's till he was 15. All of a sudden, he's on probation for defacing public property. I wouldn't even talk to his father.
My word.
Something's going on with the kid. His father's hoping maybe I can figure it out. It's the least thing I could do. What are you looking for? Why don't you fill me in? Maybe I can help you find it, whatever it is.
It's a school assignment. I have to find 10 safety hazards.
That's a good assignment. What happens if you can't find 10?
Didn't say. But I know what you're thinking, and I've got to do this myself.
Of course. I mean, I wouldn't dream of it. What the heck is that? It's a piece of loose carpet. Almost fell. Fixed.
You don't remember me, but I remember you. 'Twas not so long ago you broke my heart in two.
Oh, boy. I wish she's given up the blue light. Diane, it's been 2 months. Chuck's history. There are plenty of other guys. Mom was right. Diane, is there something we can do? I know. Maybe we can fix you up or something. You should at least think about going out and having some fun.
No. Guys are awful. They say they're gonna call and they forget. They don't listen. They're selfish. Can you name one guy you honestly trust?
Sure. There's...
Look, I'm not even interested. I'm sure there's something I could do.
Like lying here and feeling bad?
Love is not a gadget. Love is not
a toy. Dinner!
Yeah?
Diane's not eating?
I don't know. I mentioned this guy was coming and she went into another funk.
Dinner! Hurry up! Race you to the landing! What the?
That's another one. Don't run down the stairs.
Great. Just in time. Billy. These are four of my girls. Marva, Rose, Patty, and Nikki.
Hi.
Hi.
You're allowed to say hello.
Excuse me a minute.
Where are you going?
Don't you realize it's almost time for dinner?
We have to get changed.
Yeah, we wouldn't dream of coming to dinner looking like this.
I don't get it. They just did change.
That picture was 100 years old.
We could sell tickets to look at this guy.
Diane, get up. You're not gonna believe this.
I thought he was a geek with buck teeth. More like Montgomery Clift.
Uh-uh.
Fabian.
No. James Dean.
Who cares?
What are you gonna wear?
Where?
To dinner with Billy Galanto.
Don't talk to me about boys.
Did you see how it's lighted up? We feel the chills from our head.
Boys.
Billy, I know things aren't going so well at home, and, I'm here to help.
Oh, thanks.
Well, if you feel you have the need to talk things over with me, you let me know, okay?
Maybe.
Right.
They're coming!
So where's Diane?
Sorry.
And this is Billy.
I'm sorry if this is your chair.
No. Actually, this is my chair. What do you like to do, Billy?
I write, play folk music, do graffiti. It's very career-oriented. I mean, that's if you want to be a troubadour or work in the subway system.
Do you like the Weavers or Pete Seeger?
Yeah, I do.
I like the Platters, too. Did you take art history?
Yeah, and you?
I love it.
What's your favorite?
I guess the French Impressionist.
Like who?
Like Cézanne, like Monet, like Matisse. I'm going to Paris one of these days. That's where it is in fashion design.
Do you sketch, Diane?
Well, not exactly.
Well, if I make a find the Monopoly board, I'm taking on all comers.
I'm in.
Girls are killers in Monopoly.
Rose, you gotta help me. What? He's wonderful. Billy? He was interested in me, I could tell. Didn't you think so? Oh, sure. Well, you could coach me. I mean, you know everything about folk music and art and poetry. What do you want me to do? You could teach me something, anything, just to get me going. Oh, please. All right. You're the best. Oh.
Hey.
Hi.
Hey, you got a minute?
Yeah, want some?
No, thanks. You know, tonight was fun. It's the first time I've ever won $20,000 in two hotels.
Good behavior time. We always let the guests get boardwalk.
You got a nice family.
I like it too.
Even your sister?
She sure does.
No kidding. She got a boyfriend.
Diane? Not anymore.
No, no. I was thinking about Rose.
Rose?
Yeah, Rose. Good night, Patty.
Good night. Rose.
To you too.
Sorry, Nick. I gotta see if you remembered to set the brake.
Say, Clapper.
Oh, good afternoon, Gov. You're home a bit early.
Don't tell my boss.
Huh? Right, you are.
What's the matter with the stove?
Inspector Mickey needed to check the pilot lights.
Did we pass muster?
Much to the inspector's dismay.
Is everybody home?
Indeed they are, sir.
What about Billy? All settled in?
I believe so. He's in the garage.
The what? Talk American.
In the garage.
Oh, the garage. Hi. Any luck, little one?
No.
I'll hang in there. By the way, I think Clapper needs you in the kitchen.
Rose, you're the one who knows all this stuff. Literature, art, even Shakespeare. I mean, you played Juliet.
Well, you took an art class in junior high, didn't you?
Mm-hmm. Ceramics.
Well, what about poetry? Everybody knows some poetry.
Yeah, Mary had a little lamb, its fleece was white as snow.
Okay. Let me think. I got it.
Your poetry.
What?
I could use some of your poetry.
It's not that good.
Yes, it is. Besides, he'll think I'm creative.
Rose, I need you.
Can it wait? I'm helping Diane.
It'll just take a minute.
One math problem.
Sorry, I'll be right back.
I know what you're doing. You can't.
What are you talking about?
Billy asked me about you.
Billy? He's interested in me?
Very. Forget it. If he asks you again, tell him I'm going to be a nun.
Are you crazy? He's gorgeous.
Patty, I can't.
Why?
Because it means too much to Diane.
Rose.
Just forget it, okay?
What are you doing?
I'm customizing the car.
You're customizing a like-new $7,000 car?
Mass production means no personality, Nick.
People have personalities. Cars have resale value.
You are
what you drive.
What are you doing? Personalizing a carburetor?
Nah, just souping it up a little bit. I mean, these Bel Air Hills are tough.
Marva, give us a few minutes alone.
Yeah, well, don't take too long. I gotta finish my stripes, then start on the initial.
Marva, no stripes, no initials. Yellow's fine. You didn't mention Grease Monkey, Mr. Renaissance Man.
It gives me another career option.
Well, you're a smart kid. It's a start.
Come on, Nick. You said no lectures.
Call your father since you've been here.
I don't have anything to say to him. We don't speak the same language.
How about a simple I miss you? Is that too chatty for you? But Billy, when you were a kid, you used to tell me about everything. Why don't you? Oh, I forgot. I'm over 30. What the hell could I possibly? You like to write, you like to draw. I've got a new ad campaign coming up. I can give you a start. Maybe that's another career option for you. Being a rude punk. I'm not sure how well it pays.
I can't.
Yes, you can. Pick it up at Watching, Waiting.
Watching, waiting, listening in the night. Alert, responsive, caring guaranteed. Mother, did you lie to me? With pinafores and lace-trimmed bobby socks and tales of perfect people? A child skips before he reads.
Ties knots before he ties a bow. How like you, a mother aches to save his pain. Tries to shelter him. How like me, watching, waiting, listening in the night. Alert, responsive, caring, guaranteed. Mother, I know you try to tell me there are no perfect people, only perfect moments.
Well?
It's beautiful. I mean, I don't know what to say. It's just, it's kind of unexpected.
Well, I haven't put the music to it yet, but I think it's going to be a great folk song. I just hope my teacher likes it.
Likes it? Diane, you should send this to one of the quarterlies. I'd swear they'd publish it.
You think so?
In a minute. Really, it's beautiful.
Maybe we could work together on the music.
And I'd love to see more of your writing.
Well, I wish I could, but I have so much homework to do. Shakespeare, my favorite.
Shakespeare? No kidding. No, I would have never pictured you with Macbeth.
Are you serious? I love Macbeth. What a guy.
Right, what a guy.
I'll see you later.
Okay.
Oh, Billy, by the way, I played Juliet in the school play.
Really?
Thanks, Rose. It's going great.
You're still long. What's wrong with you today? Here, try the pitching wedge.
9-iron.
Are you kidding? This isn't Pebble Beach. You're gonna go right over the wall.
I taught you the game 2 weeks ago. All of a sudden, you're an expert. 9-iron.
Nick, you're going over the wall.
That's impossible. I know what you're thinking, but there's no way that I can hit it over that wall with a 9. You all right, Clapper?
Well, that was a close one. Some maniac must have... Oh, it's a nice shotgun.
Thanks, Nick. No one at school will ever have this safety hazard.
Give me the wedge.
We must be crazy. Come on. Rose, you might write great poetry, but you're not romantic. This is romantic. All right. Now, I want you to stay where he can't see you. I think I've got it memorized, but just in case, if I do this, give me the lines very quietly.
Diane.
Hi. I was just,
Wait. Don't spoil the moment. What light from yonder window breaks? It is the east. And Juliet is the sun.
Rose! He's doing Romeo and Juliet. What am I gonna say?
Thou knowest the mask of night is on my face.
Thou knowest the mask of night is on my face.
Else would a maiden blush be paint my cheek.
Else would a maiden blush be paint my cheek.
For that which thou hast heard me speak tonight.
For that which thou hast heard me speak tonight.
Wait a second. Juliet is supposed to be on the balcony.
I don't mind if you don't.
I'm coming down.
Okay, but just for a minute.
Wait right there.
Oh my God, he's coming down. You don't need me. Thank you.
Thank you. movie theaters are there? Thousands? How many homes are there? Millions, right? I'm telling you, the future is in TV. And that's our target for Foley's Just as Fresh Home Popcorn.
Great idea. Now, we know we've got a good product. The key to putting it over is going to be packaging and advertising. What do you got, Marty?
All right, we'll make our containers like the Stripe Theater boxes.
Terrific. What else?
Then we'll billboard our print ads, you know, like movie marquees, with a special Foley logo, you know, lots of searchlights, kind of like an opening night.
Perfect. All right, let's get cracking on it. We've only got 3 months before production. It's a killer idea, Nick. We'll get on it right away. Marty. Great job. Pretty exciting process, huh?
Sounds like a good deal, Nick.
You, got some ideas there?
I don't think so.
Hey, don't be bashful. Advertising might be the thing for you. Let me see what you got.
Sorry.
Don't be sorry. Actually, it's very good. Not exactly appropriate, but very good.
What's not appropriate?
Look, you're Joey Galanto's kid. You're my godson, and I love you. I don't think you're ready for any serious romance until you get your head on straight. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. Look, I know you're trying to help, but I'm not interested in drawing popcorn boxes and writing jingles.
Just don't worry about me.
I can't help worrying about you.
Just because my father saved your life doesn't make you responsible for me.
Look, Billy, if you really want to throw your life away, you're going to do it no matter what anybody says. But I just want you to realize one thing. Your father would risk his life for me. What do you think he'd do for you? Go home, Billy. Whatever it is that's bugging you, let him in on it. Talk to your old man.
I made up my mind. I'm not going back. Cloudy today.
I know.
The golf bag's in the convertible, Gov.
Thanks, Clapper. By the 18th hole, the rest of the foursome's gonna be reaching for their checkbooks.
Yeah, I think you better take your umbrella, Gov. Looks a bit chancy.
Not in a day when I shoot a scratch game. I can feel it in my bones. You gotta think positive. Put that thing back in the closet.
Remember now, modern poets under the thermos. Director of films you've actually seen and he probably liked, The Last Napkin. And one new poem in the notebook. You know, I'm probably not gonna use this anyway. He's hooked. Oh, it's so am I.
Hi, guys. How about a matinee? Something called Dr. No just opened.
Anybody ever hear of Sean Connery?
We having a picnic?
No, Patty. Billy and I are having lunch al fresco.
Huh? That's a picnic. Well, guys, I'm all set. How do I look?
Very nice.
Yes, well.
Patty, give it a few years. You'll find a Billy someday. It might rain. Not on this parade.
You're right, Rose. She's practically forgotten all about Chuck.
I saw La Strada. That's when I knew Fellini was a cinematic giant.
Oh, he is. He is definitely a giant.
You know, I hadn't cried since I was a kid, but that woman was so vulnerable. I mean, how can a guy treat a woman like that? It doesn't have to be that way.
I agree.
Hey, I've been monopolizing this conversation.
Be my guest.
What's the matter? Did the creative muse desert you today?
I hope not.
What?
Nothing.
How about a drink? Do you like Ferlinghetti?
You too.
Ah, Coney Island of the Mind. It's fabulous.
I don't know where you came from. But do me a favor. Don't get lost.
I won't.
Hi! Hey, don't mind me. You seen any gophers? I only need to find one gopher hole. You can trip really bad on a gopher hole. Especially if you're wearing high heels.
Mickey, get lost. Right this minute.
It's going to rain anyway.
It's not gonna rain. Now beat it. Can you believe this?
It's kind of romantic if you ask me.
Look, even the brownies got soaked.
Oh, come on, Juliet. This is no time for earthly concerns. The heavens have opened up and chased the gopher hunters away. Now it's just the two of us.
Amen.
Not a great day for a picnic, huh? Someday I'll be able to forget. The best round of golf I almost got to play.
Yeah, I think this picnic's over.
We could bring it in the house.
Why do I think the mood might not be quite right? How about a real date? Tonight, a movie or something.
Deal.
I got a surprise for you. That's if the weather clears up and I can finish it.
Damn rain. Those fish are sitting around the clubhouse cheering about how they slipped my hook.
Oh, you'll be able to have another go at them, Gov.
Yeah. Once they know they're fish, they're worthless.
Have any luck with Billy, Gov?
I've had better conversations with celery. Needed oregano. Hey, it's better already.
Oh, we do seem a bit tense.
His father's expecting to hear from me. How am I going to call? What am I going to say to him?
Well, people need time to find themselves.
Some people never find themselves. Whenever you're serving a kid for dinner, go heavy on the wisdom. Needs more basil, too.
Come on, Marva, think. I only need two more.
All right, did you look under the sink for poison stuff babies can get into?
Marva, we don't have any babies.
Oh, yeah, right. Oh, what about oily rags? They're always good hazards.
I looked.
Sorry, babe. But if I see too many plugs in the socket, you'll be the first one I call.
Hey, Mickey. Any luck?
I didn't find a single gopher hole. And no oily rags.
Oh, I'm sorry. Can you give this to Diane anyway? She left it outside, and I'm afraid some of the rain got to it.
Yeah. Kind of a mess. But it isn't Diane's. It belongs to Rose. Maybe some of it'll
die. It belongs to Rose? Are you sure?
Of course it's Rose. I can tell. All her poetry's in it. I'll give it to her.
No, that's okay, thanks. I think I better try and dry it out first, okay? Hi.
Hi.
Can I show you something?
Sure. That's
really nice, Billy. Nick's right, you're talented.
Think so, really? You know, I want to write something to go with it for Diane, but I just don't have a way with words the way she does, you know?
It's hard.
There are no perfect people, only...
perfect moments.
Diane's a terrific writer.
She is.
I found your notebook.
I'm sorry.
Why, Rose?
She asked me to help her, and I wanted to.
What do I do now?
I don't know.
You really haven't been very fair to me.
I can't hurt Diane, no matter what.
I know. I wouldn't expect any less from the person who wrote those words. Just one kiss, Rose.
Please let me explain.
Diane, open the door.
My heart is full of broken dreams, all because of silly plans and schemes. Happiness is just an illusion filled with sadness.
Daughters aren't speaking to each other, and the object of their affection is jumping ship. What's next? Somebody gonna yell iceberg ahead?
Nick, I didn't think they were.
Look, I know what happened. It's not your fault.
I just don't want you to think I was just flirting.
Let's say goodbye to Rose.
I can't.
What about Diane? I guess that puts them in pretty good company. Your old man. See you around, kid.
Wait. Nick, I don't want to throw my life away.
Then what are you doing?
What's going on up here? I'm just trying to get by.
Get by? Wow, that's a wonderful thing to strive for in life.
I'm no war hero, Nick. And I'm not going to go out and conquer the business world.
Who asked you to?
Nobody asked me to. But I just can't measure up. I don't even want to try anymore.
Billy, let me ask you something. Did your father ever push you too hard?
No.
Did he ever compare himself to you?
Not really.
Then why do you think like that?
Because I'll never be the man he is.
Let me tell you something about your father. He made a lot of money. He never forgot what's important. He's got a heart. He's got spirit. He's got a soul. That's the only place where you got to measure up to him. You understand? And you do, Billy. Spades. The old man has a lot in common.
Besides being two punks from Hoboken?
Yeah, we're both lucky we got a Billy Galanto in our lives.
Thanks, Nick. Diane, it's me, and I'm leaving, and I gotta talk to you. I'm sorry about what you saw. But don't blame Rose. She wouldn't have hurt you even if it meant keeping all of her feelings to herself. And the way it was with us, it couldn't have lasted much longer.
Probably not.
You know, there's a beautiful girl in this picture. I might have liked her, but I've really gotten to know her.
Thanks. I hope you're right. Roses are red, violets are blue. This lousy poem is all I could do.
Rose. Rose.
Go ahead. It's your window.
Hi.
Hi.
You can't be mad at me.
I'm not.
Good. Because I might come back.
Why?
A lot of good art schools out here.
Right. So where are you going?
Maybe New Jersey. All right.
Not Shakespeare.
No. Pure Galanto.
Joey, don't worry about it. Everything's going to be fine. Now, look, I'll let him tell you about it face to face when he sees you. He's a real nice boy, Joey. Just a good thing he looks like his mother. I still don't understand what you ever saw in a monkey like you. What the?
Nick, I found another one. It's the fuse box.
Joey, maybe you can return the favor.
You see, I got this 8-year-old who just might need a vacation.